My name is Elias Morales. I'm a mechanical engineer, but I'm also a language teacher. Today, you know, Silvia Cortez is with me. She's a language teacher too. We've been working for a while on this topic. Okay, before we start, if you want to download the material, you can take a picture of the QR code, and later you can download it. Question, who's from Mexico City? Here? We don't have that many. From Puebla? Nobody.
Yeah,
from Veracruz? Yes. We have one from there, two from there, right? So let's think farther. From Tijuana? No. From Cancun? Nobody.
Tamaulipas?
Guanajuato, Durango. Okay, so welcome again, and we shall begin. So this is the two main objectives for this small session. The first one is discuss what you think the materials are, how can we recognize them, and how you are, or your co-workers are adapting them in classes. Maybe you are doing it right now and you haven't noticed. Maybe you haven't done it and you can do it now. And the other main objective for this session is we're going to have a little bit of interaction between the people next to you. And we're going to design at least two activities for a specific level using authentic materials according to your language. Okay, this is the outline two. First, a small introduction of the topic. Then, the main theoretical framework. Some examples, training activity design, some feedback presentations of your own, and the question and answer section. So, I ask you a little bit of applause for my partner, Jana Cecilia.
Hello, everyone. Thank you.
Okay, for this text-driven approach, we took an example. As an example, it's an advertisement, but it can be used for any kind of text. Second approach is multi-dimensional approach. We use a YouTube video, but you can use text, video, audio, anything. And finally, critical awareness development. We are using a Canadian news program, and the same, you can use a text or different materials. Let's start with text-driven approach. Okay, in this text-driven approach, we have six stages. The stage number one has as principle to create a personal connection. Students can, for example, relate their previous knowledge, information. You could ask to look at the image and think about when was the last time they swimming, picture that image in their minds. For stage number two, we present our material and we ask them to think about their rules, the full rules that they know, they remember, because maybe they have been in a pool at least once in their life. And this has projected to create affective and cognitive engagement. An example could be just to mention or to remember those examples. The third stage is create interactions. Now the students will share with a partner or in small groups the rules that they remember, and they will start getting engaged with our material and the topic. The fourth stage has an aim to develop a purposeful communication, and we'll make a first development activity in which the learner will create an own version, a local version. He will change maybe the rules for images, he will draw a picture, add the link for some more rules, and explain why. So far, we haven't analyzed the grammar. Finally, for stage number 5 and 6, we have one, they're going to analyze the grammar. In this case, for full rules, they will analyze the basic level imperatives, make a general rule, make a list of imperatives, and how do we use them. And for activity number 6, they will improve their previous version on stage number 4. And now with the information that they have about grammar, they will integrate that information to create a final product. Now let's move to approach number 2. In this approach, we're using a video. I would like to look at the picture. Do you know this blogger? Okay, please, let's watch the video. And tell me what do you notice particularly about it?
I think she's very talented. Sin is somebody I hear over and over again, like how beautiful she is. But again, like I've never seen a photo of her. I've never had her described. I think she's very talented, but I just don't picture her being, I don't know, like anything like crazy. I don't know, like I picture her being kind of like plain looking. I picture her being very simple looking, like minimal makeup, not super glammed out, like just very simple. I feel like her personality is just very down to earth, and to me that like goes along with being like simple, you know, like she doesn't put too much effort into her hair or her makeup or her clothes. She's just like, this is what I look like, walk out the door. I could see her having like maybe like collarbone length hair. Something that she, like an easy style, that she doesn't have to like work with too much. Maybe just like a nice straight little or like maybe some wave to it. So I picture it being like maybe like a nice like natural wave, you know, like it's not like she like she didn't do beach waves in her hair, it's just like naturally wavy. I could see her having really pretty eyes though, like really nice blue green eyes. And I feel like she's very, very fair skinned as well. Like I feel like she would be like my skin tone. Yeah, I think she probably has a very similar complexion to me. Like very fair, freckles. I could see her having like just a really like a pretty smile, you know? Like yeah, you look at her and think she has like a pleasing face, but it's nothing like, oh my goodness, so unobtainable. I don't know. That's how I picture her. And I picture her being slim build, like petite frame. 5'4" around there, and yeah, being like not overly curvaceous.
Okay.
What did you notice about her?
Your eyes are
Why do you think she's doing that? Yes, you're right. Her name is Molly Burgul. She lives in Los Angeles. And she's a blogger. She makes videos about her daily life. In this case, she was explaining how the Emma Watson looked like for her in her imagination. I use this video for basic level. What or how would you use this video? For which level? People appear physical appearance, yes. Miller, what about advanced level? Comparatives and superlatives, yes. Alright, well, here in this approach specifically, we have the interaction between teachers and students, because with this material we will inspire and encourage our students to look for different authentic materials. They will work with this video. We could design a pre-watching activity, and you know, introducing some vocabulary. After that, while watching, propose some questions, gut feeling. After that, we do a post-watching, and in this case, they can also add an interpretation. When they start manipulating this material, they can go to the second stage, in which we look forward to make students creative, and they will look for a video. It could be as another video or text of a description of Emma Watson or any other celebrity. It could be to find other videos with a similar theme, with descriptions, with personality. And after that, they could share why they chose that video, that authentic material, that text, compare their findings and present it to the class. Here we are developing autonomy, responsibility. We are giving more interaction between learners and more responsibility for them to create their own activities and to look for their own sources. Finally, let's go to the third approach, which is critical awareness development. Do you know the guy in the picture? Who is him? Have you heard about the elbow gate?
Well, in 2011, well, this guy was running for his party in Canada, there was this session, different from Mexico, Canadian Parliament wrote the bills in a set of time. They say this hour, this day, if you don't get the law passing through the Parliament by this time, you can get it. So, again, they're running out of time for both main parties in the Parliament and discussing these laws going in or not. So at that time, Trudeau was pretty politic, pretty famous then, and he runs, he steps on his chair, he goes through the center of the discussion, and he grabs one of the members of his party, like, sit down, and let me talk. That was what he did, that was he saw. But around, something else happened. So this video is for you. You see what else happened for those short seconds in the Parliament of Canada. So let's watch it, and you will tell us what really happened.